So we know Kashmir means paradise of the earth, but when we hear the word Kashmir, we have a fear also. Spontaneously, we comes a fear also because of a terrorist activities. So you are from Kashmir, and how you feel Kashmir is?
Yeah, naturally, as you said that Kashmir is a paradise. That's definitely it's a paradise, but. There is a fear among the people about when they hear this name Kashmir. That is because of the increasing terrorism there, and the roots of that terrorism are in the basically the political support that they get from the across the border. There is a Pakistan sponsored terrorism is there, and they are trained in across the border in the Pakistani land, and they are equipped, and then they are transported to India. And of course the local support is also there, local people also support that, and then they do all these terrorist activities. And this is purely a kind of brainwashed. These people are brainwashed. They don't have any ideology. The only ideology is their, jihadist. It is not a something that they are, looking for freedom or something. But it is a purely a mind washed because of that, jihadist indoctrination of those people. And what we saw in 1990s, the genocide of Kashmiri Pandits. It is a outcome of the indoctrination that has taken place over the decades, and then it was it was manifested in the form of that exodus. And till date the Kashmiri Pandits have been refugees in their own home actually. So why they are not able to go back to their homes is because of this continuous threat. Even if they want to go back, they feel unsafe. Why they feel unsafe is that you have seen in the recent past, last few months, the terrorists actually, they are targeting the local people. Local in the sense that those workers who are coming from Bihar or any other part of this country, they are being unnecessarily targeted. It is a frustration of the terrorists. And that frustration is for because of normalcy. As and when there is a kind of normalcy in Kashmir, they get frustrated that normalcy is coming back in Kashmir, and then we have to create a kind of terrorism, a terrorism atmosphere we have to create in the valley, so that a normal peace is disturbed, and so that a kind of disturbance remains there forever. So that is the main roots of the terrorism.
So how you feel Kashmir before and after Narendra Modi ji's prime ministership?
Narendra Modi ji's arrival is a kind of a good big hope for the people of Jammu and Kashmir, especially in 2014 when Modi ji came in the center. They had to make an alliance with the PDP actually. So, but after that, this alliance was not that much good. There were some issues within that, and but somehow it was what I see it as a strategic move by the government of led by Narendra Modi. And. And then in 2019, when a decision to revoke the Article 370 was taken, it was a kind of a dream come true for the people of India, because people were longing for years to become one with the rest of the country. They were alienated from rest of the India, and just because of the 370 article. And this 370 article was a tool that was sustaining, feeding, and promoting only few families, few political families, be it National Conference or be it People's Democratic Party. Actually, both the parties were filling their stomach. They were running their businesses, and they were not allowing the full-fledged integration of the state of Jammu and Kashmir with the rest of India. This was a kind of institutional or a constitutional shielding. It was 370 was used as a constitutional shield to hide their wrongdoings that were happening in Kashmir, because what they want, this Article 370 was such that, you know, no law of the state of the government of India was applicable to the state of Jammu and Kashmir until you pass it through the Assembly of Jammu and Kashmir. So nowhere in India such kind of a situation is there. So that was the politics of convenience, I would say. The convenient laws, which were, you know, convenient to the establishment of Jammu and Kashmir, they used to implement in their assembly, that too not as it is, but through some amendments, because that was the power given to them through Article 370. And they were twisting the laws and, you know, amending it in their own ways and then implementing it. And once it was removed, now people are happy, the state has become one with the rest of the country. Now we have only one constitution, one nation, one flag. Earlier we had two flags, and we didn't like that, like this. People of Jammu and Kashmir didn't like this. And after the arrival of Modi ji, Amit Shah, and the whole nationalist party at the center, people are very happy. Especially there are schemes now. The central schemes are directly being implemented in Jammu and Kashmir. There is a central university in Ladakh, central university in Jammu, in Kashmir also. Then we have AIIMS already starting in Jammu and Kashmir. There is a IIM, IIT is also there. So we are seeing a sea change in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, and we hope that in the future also this continuous process will be going on, and people will get rid of those political parties that were enjoying by using the constitutional machinery through the Article 370.
The Kashmiri Pandits also returning back to the place. No?
Kashmiri Pandits.
Migrated to outside Kashmir?
As of now, many are still outside only, but as such, there was some news that, you know, some colonies are being established. But as of now, there is no concrete plan. They have not, you know, settled back. Although here and there may be some kind of isolated cases, but still that kind of situation is not there. You see that the recent past, you know, they are killing the Hindu people, selectively they are targeting the Hindus. So under these situations, the Kashmiri Pandits will not take a risk of going back unless there is a full security of their life, their property, and their, you know, kids, their future, the future of their kids is secure. Until that, it may not be possible for their return. Their properties are already there. Some of the those properties are, you know, taken over by the other people. But the steps should be taken to return their properties back to the Kashmiri Pandits. Then only, you know, it can be the dream of their returning back to Kashmir can be realized.
So what is the current scenario there?
The currently the government is run by Lieutenant Governor, and they are doing good. You know, the central, as I told, central schemes are directly being implemented. You know, central, especially the central schemes, be it recent, the example of the FRA, the Forest Rights Act, has been extended to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. There are so many activities within that are going on, because there is a sizable population of tribal people in Jammu and Kashmir, be it Gaddis, Gujjars, Bakrawals. They were neglected till date, and they were devoid of their basic rights, and Forest Rights Act provides them their rights, and it has been implemented, and it is implemented in a big way, and rights have been already given to many of the families. Other thing is the Valmiki families, you might have heard about. Those people, they were brought to Jammu and Kashmir long back by Sheikh Abdullah. Why? Because the people, the local karmacharis actually were not doing, that kind of menial work. And then Sheikh Abdullah went to Punjab and they brought some families from there to Jammu and Kashmir to do that scavenging work and all. But there was a deal between the state of Punjab and Sheikh Abdullah at that time that once these people are here, we will give them citizenship, we will give them jobs and all other facilities that are available to the residents of Jammu and Kashmir. But unfortunately, till 2019, they were languishing here and there. They were not given the basic rights. They were not the residents of Kashmir or the residents of Punjab. So they are languishing altogether. They were not even able to apply in the jobs of the Jammu and Kashmir. So once the Article 370 was removed, those people, got the domicile of the state of Jammu and Kashmir, and now they are equal with the rest of the people of Jammu and Kashmir, and they are very happy now. And these are some of the changes at the level of socio-political developments.